My name is Joel Solomon. I am the technology specialist here at Village East Elementary.
I'm Justin Cantrell. I'm a counselor at Thunder Ridge Middle School.
My name is Carrie Joyce. I teach 8th grade writing at Thunder Ridge Middle School.
If you ask kids, they'd probably say it's like a Lego world or it's an unlimited world. So Minecraft is basically an open sandbox game where it's also open source. So there's no linear path that you follow. You can just make it whatever you want. So kids can play in two different modes, creative mode where they can just have unlimited inventory and make what they want, or they can play in a survival mode situation where they have to learn how to make their own materials, gather their own food, and survive the night. Either way, the EDU is only available to schools, and it comes with a set of mods that allow teachers to manage players much more easily. And it also allows you to set up a self-contained learning environment. So I have it set up in the lab, and the kids can only see what is in our computer lab. No one from the outside can join in. And the EDU version, especially with Minecraft, I've told kids I can teach any subject. You tell me what you're learning, and I can use Minecraft to teach it. I think it's phenomenal to me. Why I love this game so much is it's highly engaging. It's whatever you want it to be. So, and kids are drawn to that.
That Minecraft is about surprises, and that Minecraft is a fun game while you learn.
Yeah, I get to use my imagination and build whatever I want.
So you kind of get to define the game, how you play the game, and there's really no right or wrong way to play the game. And I think that especially middle school kids, that's really attractive. Because, I mean, in school, you're so much is, there. Here's your goal, and you need to meet it, and here's how we're going to meet it. Whereas in video game world, you kind of get to set your own goals, and I think that's really attractive to kids.
I think they're drawn to kind of the collaborative experience. I mean, having the computer in front of you and kind of doing your own thing, but also kind of researching, and especially in our group here, being part of a club where they can interact with others to create something bigger than themselves.
Yeah, doing everything to hunting, to building, to socializing with friends.
Every single kid wants to play and learn how to play and figure out what I'm setting forth for them to do.
Minecraft, my favorite part is that we all work together.
What I like best about Minecraft is all the cooperation, because you can like cooperate with your teammate and get to know them better.
I think that's the beauty of this game, is that it has so many different skills that are both curriculum related, technology related, socially related. It does it all, and the kids love it. So I want to do something the kids want to do, because that's what motivates them. I've started with kindergarten and all the way through fifth, so everybody's doing it, every single class. Our kindergartners, I'm using it more to teach fine motor skills and how to manipulate the keyboard and use a mouse and right and left click, so my goals are different. And with older kids, they're learning more curriculum-based activities.
Here at Thunder Ridge, we have our after-school Minecraft club, and that's definitely team building, making social connections, digital citizenship, leadership skills.
So teamwork has really been the theme of everything that we've done here.
So in the beginning, I talk about 21st century skills. So the kids all know the four C's, which is communication, collaboration, critical thinking, and creativity. And they're also learning the objectives that I put forth for standards-based learning.
So I noticed there were just a lot of kids that obviously played Minecraft that didn't have a lot of connections that they were making on their own at school, and I thought it'd be cool to bring them all into one place where they could make those connections with one another and with new adults in the building that they don't normally interact with, and just create a bigger, better experience for them here at Thunder Ridge.
So when I use my higher kids at playing Minecraft, they now have an opportunity to be a leader. And what you see is some kids that in the classroom may not stand out as leaders become leaders in Minecraft because they play the game at home. So they can come and feel successful and feel that someone is depending on them to increase their knowledge, which to me helps them feel more empowered. So the kids that are acquiring language can use Minecraft because it's so visual that they're not limited by their language, and that they can learn the language through the gaming environment. And so when you learn how to work together and you see your partners in little cubey worlds with each other, you can see their faces light up and they start smiling. Because my Minecraft club that meets after school, we are focused on creating settings from books. So the kids were starting with the Three Little Pigs. So we started with something simple, that I knew their materials existed in Minecraft. So they're building the straw house, they're building the stick house and the brick house, and some of the kids are building the chimney, and they're being authentic to the story of making sure that the wolf falls through the chimney into the fire at the end. And I've taught them how to add the characters, so they're adding the pigs and the wolves as well.
Another teacher introduced Lord of the Flies by having the kids, when they start the game, they're on an island. And he just said, just try to survive, work together to survive. And it played out exactly like Lord of the Flies does. They work together for a while, chaos ensues, the kids started attacking each other to get resources and for fun, and you know, one was put in charge, and so it just kind of devolved into chaos, just like it does in the book.
So I've been through Advantage Math training, and we talked about symbolic representation and linguistic and quantitative, so I wanted to have kids create something in Minecraft that shows the different ways they can make a number.
We learned about numeracy and showing numbers in many different ways. We show it by putting down blocks for equations, some that we put down for to show arrays, and sometimes for example like base 10 blocks. There's also two more that you can place down animals to show it, and you can place down blocks to write it, and you can plant to show how much your number is worth.
I like best, like all the cooperation, and I didn't know there were so many ways to show a number. Like, for example, I chose 20, and I didn't know you could use it in so many ways until today.
Kids that learn how to help each other in a game are more likely to help each other in the real world. So just because it's a game doesn't mean there's not learning going on. Right? What they all say is, this is fun. And that, to me, is what learning should be. It should be fun.
I love to explore in the game, and it's just really fun.
I think everyone should play it because it's really fun and grow up really.